And welcome back. Okay. Episode 9. I got something special for everybody today. We will not be doing Photoshop today. I'm going to be working in Illustrator. Yes, that's right. I'm a multi-talented artist, and I can draw in Illustrator as well. Actually, I enjoy Illustrator and Photoshop. So today, I'm going to be working on a piece I did as a sketch over the last week. And I just think it needs a little more work done to it. I really liked where it was going and decided, you know what, this needs to be made into something a little more special. So, as you know, this week Stephen Hawking passed away, and it wasn't unexpected, but it was kind of sad, and nobody wanted to see him leave. He's such a smart guy and such a advocate for science and human that whole quest for knowledge and learning. He's such an inspiration. So I did this piece, and I'll switch over here now. There we go, over there it shows. So I did this piece last week, and it was for a couple of reasons. One is I'm part of a daily sketch group. I don't always post daily, but I try. Just getting started there. And the topic came up before we knew about his passing. And the topic for the day of his passing was something an irresponsible time traveler would leave behind. And, I kind of struggled with that. I came up with some various ideas, somebody leaving a physics book in ancient Egypt or something like that, something silly that would obviously change the course of time. I heard about his passing, and that just kind of sat on me for the rest of the day. And then it finally dawned on me, why not do something with Stephen Hawking? And I remembered that he'd held this time traveler convention, and as a test to see if anybody actually could time travel. He sent out invitations the day after the event, right? into the future. And so I thought, how appropriate is it that I would get that topic and have his passing. And so, I decided, let's work with that. And so I found a nice little quote from him, and I've added that into here already too. So it says, "The past, like the future, is indefinite and exists only in a spectrum of possibilities." And, I'll edit this later to be spaced better. I just threw it in there. And this is based on one of the photos taken of him at the convention, and obviously I removed him from the chair. It's got the welcome banner and his chair. So what I'm going to do is, in Illustrator here, is I'm going to try and recreate this into something that could be used as a nice little print, you could put up on a wall, or maybe, I don't think it really t-shirt material, but maybe, just see where it goes from there. So, I've already got a couple layers here. I've got my layer one, which we will title it my sketch layer. And we've got layer two, and debating on where to start, but I think I'm going to start right on the chair. So, let's call this chair layer. Chair. All right. We can kind of zoom in on this, and what I'm going to do first is, because this chair is all black, right? So what we'll do is we'll just block it in as black at first. So what I want to do is we'll just do that now. Usually what I'll do is I'll work in a different color than what I want it to be. I never work with the fills on. I really don't like working with the fills on. And we'll just see where we get on this thing. So let's start up here. We'll just start. That's not it. All right, let's just try again. All right, so let's just do that. Now we're gonna come down here. Let's see, right about there. Yeah. Over there. All the way over here. So yeah, we'll adjust this. So yeah, what I'm doing is I'm just adding points, just going right in with the pen tool and adding points. And yeah, once I get that added in, I can come back and kind of adjust the shape a little bit. Use the white arrow for this. So you can see it's not quite right shape here, so we'll just bring this out a little bit. Yeah, that's so that we get to kind of fix my pencil sketch at this point too, right? So find the mistakes and I don't want that handle. Yeah, it's not what I wanted. Yeah, find the mistakes, fix them, clean it up a bit. So this will have nice clean lines on it. I might add a little bit of my Illustrator style to it. I've got a little bit of an Illustrator style that I've developed over the years. So I might add that into the picture as well. That way it doesn't look like it's a photocopy or anything like that. Yeah, so what I do now is I take this and where is that tool? It's been a few weeks since I used this. Not here somewhere. Oh, where are you? Slice? No, it's not slice. Knife tool. There we go. Okay, knife tool. This is it. So what I'll do is I'll take this and I'll copy it. We'll see Control V, right? And zoom out a little bit. Don't want both of those. Okay, so drag that one over. And I'll reposition that one in a minute. So what I want to do is I want to take this. You see it's got the shading on the side here. I got that wrong, but anyway. So what I want to do is just kind of come in here with my knife, come down, and back out. Voila, right? And so what I do with this is I only want one piece of it. So we get rid of that piece. And then we can take this and move it back over. And make sure it's in the back still, right? And to back, and I'll zoom back in on this. And we'll go about doing some edits on it. Get this the way I want it. Let's see, so we want it to be about that deep. Okay, now you see I'm missing a anchor point here. So what we will do is come up here, get my pen tool, and we will add an anchor point. And we'll add it in right there. Boom, add our anchor point. Because we need two anchor points to do this, right? Right. And shoot back up so you're in line there. Perfect. Perfect. And then we'll take you. Oops. Drop you. Perfect. That's not quite right. Let's try and straighten this out a bit so it's. Seems mostly parallel. There we go, that's about right. Pull that in. Okay, good. What did I want to do? I want to do something with you. We want to give you round points. And there. Okay, good. Alright. So we have our headrest. Yay, headrest. It's got some sort of handle coming out the back. It's got the neck piece that holds it up, and it's got the backrest. You know, one thing I could do is just kind of block everything in and then just add detail. And that might be the smart thing to do on this, is just block it in. And then we'll go in over the top with other stuff to make it pop a little more. And I think that might be the best idea. I'm going to do that. I'm gonna just do the lower chair. All is a block. I'm just going to follow it around. Alright, spin tool, alright, so let's start up here. I'm just going right down the back of the chair. And come out here, give it a little bit of a twist. Let's see. No, I don't want that to be. That I want to be squared. This was something like a, kind of like a medical bag of some kind sitting right here. Didn't seem attached to anything. Oh gosh, it came down. I had like some straps on it of some kind. Sure, if I looked, I could find a better picture of his chair to use. Let's see. Yeah, so what I'm just doing is I'm coming around and outlining the chair and its components, and then we'll just add detail on top. Now I am using mouse on this. I'm more comfortable using mouse than my tablet. I know that might seem odd, but I am. I prefer the mouse here. Let's see that. Going right on down, and this is going to be the rear wheel. Oh, yeah, okay, I remember how that goes. Yeah, okay, so now we do the wheel here. I guess that was just shadow I was trying to draw earlier there. That was a quick sketch. Yeah, like I said, I could have just grabbed the photo and worked directly from the photo, but I want to work from my sketch because, yeah, it's a little more organic feeling working from the sketch. Okay, I see that, okay, we're going to come up and then out. That's not going to work. We got to go shorter distance to get this started. There we go, I like that. Curve there. There we go. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, we're doing this. It's coming along. Yeah. Halfway done with this part. That's the other wheel I'm trying to show there. I think it is. Oh, it does come up to here. Kind of with that. Yeah, that works. Let's see, do I want to do the monitor in this batch? Maybe I might save that for later. We'll just get around the chair, and then we'll come back and do the monitor and that arm. Yeah, I think so. I'll do that. I don't really care a whole lot what's there. There we go. And close it up. Ta-da. There we go. And now we can go in with this and do some minor adjustments to kind of make it look better. Right. Okay, looking better, looking good. I didn't like how this was shaped back here when I did it the first time. Maybe I could kind of fix that up for my sketch. That's interesting. Oh, I ended up with sewing. Dots there. Okay. All right. Let's see. I don't want to add. Yeah, it's not pinned to it. It automatically adds. I don't want. Oh well, must be setting. So we'll start here and work my way down. Here, it's a little far. A little too far. That's okay. Make it work. There we go. I just gotta fix this guy right here. Yeah, that's good. Right there. Okay. That's good. Alright. Might be hard to see some of this on your screen because I'm using a pretty thin line. So here, let's go ahead and pick this, and I'm going to drop gradient fill into it. Let's see, fill gradient. There we go, linear. Actually, we'll just drop that right there. Boom. That maybe add in. There we go. Let's see. I don't want it to be. Actually, I don't want it to be perfectly black on that side. So let's do that. Okay. That's okay. Let's kind of duplicate that one there. There we go, that's not bad. Okay. So Okay, so this is kind of how it's going to go with the rest of it. We'll just make that black. There we go. So, yeah, that doesn't look bad. So, we'll do that to the back of the seat. Other things. All right. So, let's keep this going. I want to do the bottom of the seat here. Oops, I got that built in. I don't want that to fill in right now. No, I don't. There we go. Put a little dip in it there. And voila, there's the top of the seat cushion. I'll come in here. Make a few edits. You see what I usually do is I'll exaggerate the line a little bit as I'm drawing. And then I'll go back in and fix the line up a little bit with how I want it to be. See, this is facing the wrong way. There we go. That looks pretty darn good. That looks pretty darn good. Okay. So I think let's do is as I get, no, I don't want to do that yet. I was thinking I could go ahead and start shading those in, but I really don't want to do that just yet. Not just yet. Soon though. Let's see. This is. See, what I want to do is I want to build front to back, right? So since this is in front of this or behind this, I kind of need to do whatever this thing is. First, I don't know what it is. It was just something on chair. You know, it looks like some sort of maybe medical device of some kind. So we're just gonna go back and outline it again. Well, this is where the knife tool might come in handy. But oh, that's okay. All right, so I'll get that in. We'll go and add. Oops, edit. Put that in the wrong spot. Let's start over here. So it looks like it's kind of a box here that sticks out from behind the chair. So let's just add in something like that. See, got that, and then we can just grab an ellipse tool and we will just go 1, 2, 3. There we go. Now, there's a come in here and we will fix that up a little bit real quick. Let's see, bring that up. And bring that up and over. Alright, let's see, that's the big line. It's okay, we can actually. That's not quite what I wanted to do, but that's okay. Make sure it outlines what we already kind of had going there. There we go. Bring that all the way down, I think. Yeah, I think I'm gonna bring that all the way down to there. I think that'll be okay. Like I said, I don't really know what's going on over here. I don't know if it's like some sort of attachment point. Let's try and make it look reasonably like it's useful. I guess. Reasonably looking sort of useful, maybe. Let's see. Yeah, and let's go ahead and keep moving here. We will keep moving. It's coming together pretty quick, I think. Yeah, we're at 25 minutes. Oh well. Now we'll see if get this done today or not. Might have to continue this on Wednesday. That would be perfectly fine with me. I am tired tonight. Normally I'm excited, I'm ready to go, and tonight, not so much. We had a birthday party this weekend for my now 13-year-old, and we had a blast. We had a lot of fun. We went and saw a production of Life Play version of Sweeney Todd, and that was well done. It was done by a small local theater group called Ludus Performing Arts, I think. And basically, they help kids, mostly teens, get ready for either acting or whatever. Doing play work, that kind of thing. And really, really a lot of fun. And they did a great job. Yeah, these were mostly high school level students, kids, I should say. But the ones that played Sweeney Todd and Miss Lovett were just spot on. I mean, wow. Yeah, you wouldn't guess that they were kids. I mean, they looked like they were ready to go to Hollywood. I mean, really, they were good. Let's see, we've got some sort of, usually chairs have various attachment points for things. I think this is one of those, like, attachment points. My wife uses a chair similar to this. She has a disability called spinocerebellar ataxia. I hope she doesn't mind me talking about it a little bit. And you know, it's something she's lived with pretty much all her life. It gets worse over time, and it's what it is. Let's see. So yeah, she's a smart, clever gal, and she takes care of herself, takes care of the kids. We've got three kids that she takes care of. I call her super mom a lot, and she says, "I'm not a super mom." It's like, yeah, you are. yeah, you are. And, for her to take care of three kids is just amazing to me. I mean, I have a hard time when I have to take care of them on my own. So I can't imagine her doing it every single day. She deserves a lot more breaks than she gets. A lot more. And I'm just not in a position to do that yet, which is why I'm doing this, sort of, I guess. Is, one day I would like to be able to, do more traveling, more adventures with the family. That kind of thing. What I do there? Oh, right, okay. Okay, I got it now. Alright, so let's bring in this thing that's back here. What we'll do is we'll just kind of cover that up. Let's see. And so what I'm doing is I'm going a little larger than what the outline is that I have. And that way it'll cover up what I color the whole back of it as. And so it'll be a much better, it'll look a lot better in the end because of that. And basically the goal is you just kind of keep moving, working your way forward through the, so you don't have to go back and rearrange your shapes. I could split this onto multiple layers. Wouldn't be a bad idea for something like this. At least, something as complicated as this chair. Let's see, I should have done these first. I think I'll just leave those the background color. It'll probably be black, but that's fine. It'll stand out from everything. Oh. Let's see, we've got some sort of box. Excuse me. like thing here. Again, I did that a little wrong. Oh well. Oops, did that connect? Yeah, that connected, didn't it? I'm not sure it did. Let's make sure that connects. There we go. Yeah, that's connected. Yeah, I think it connected before. So, yeah, this is our opportunity to kind of square this out. My son is excited. I'm going to, one of the things we're going to do here soon, I'll go ahead and announce it now. My son and I have been talking. He wants to produce his own animated show. You know, he's been learning his 3D animation and such. And yeah, I think it's good for him to kind of do his own thing rather than, you know, copying, not really copying, but, you know, using music and such and, you know, not, and non-original characters. You know, he's using characters owned by other companies. And, yeah, it's worked for him so far. But, you know, he recognizes that he needs to do something. You know what, I should have done this one first. Oh, well. You know, he recognizes he needs to do something more original once so he can actually start monetizing stuff. he's like, hey, I want to monetize. I'm getting views. I'm getting followers and all this stuff. I can't monetize anything yet because all the stuff has copyrights on it. You know, because they're not his original songs or anything. So. The original copyright owners are getting money off of his videos, and he's getting nothing, which is, you know, you know, he's okay with that. You know, this learn, you know, allows him to learn, and it's great when, you know, the original artists will notice him and, you know, mention him in a comment. Here, I just brought that to front. I should have done the bottom first and then the top. I should have done this much, much later. Oh, well. I think fading on, just leaving that black or what? I don't know. At least planes going here. So I could start adding to this what I've done and completed. Yeah, I think I will. All right, so here's what we'll do. We'll start adding in color shading on some of these. I might come later. Okay, so we want those to be, I don't know, we don't know, let's just pick something light. Yeah, what's interesting, it's going to be mostly a I think mostly a black and white type image. My light source coming. Light source is kind of coming from the front. So what do I want to do here? We want to take our gradient, and we want to do that with it, and. What we want to do is, so that's right there. All right, so what we want to do is bring that there. Green, kind of darker over here. Yeah, that looks kind of good. Bring this up to there. I'll have to spread this out a little bit. Oh, close. Close. Not quite the right angle. There we go. There's the right angle. There we go. Now we can change it a little bit. Ah, see? I've created a corner. This doesn't matter right here. This is going to be colored in solid anyways. Watch this. Boom. Boom. And boom. There it is. Okay, now this is going to have a gradient. going to go cross that. That's right in. That's what I want. And what we'll do is, I don't want to make it be black, black there, but let's put that color and put that color there. And put, color there. Yeah, good work. I think it's a little too bright though. Do that. That's not the same line, is it? Yeah, looks like it was lighter. There we go. There we go. There we go. I like that. That'll work. I mean, it's not perfect, but it'll work. Alrighty, let's do the back here. You're gonna be also a gradient. Oh, look at that. A gradient. And in fact, we're gonna try and match this as best we can. Let's see, so we'll go there, and we got going on, we got dark, and then we got not quite as dark there, and then we're going to come a little bit lighter in the center, maybe a little lighter, yeah, like that maybe. That looks good. Okay. Let's see. And then we just got to change the angle a little bit. Not there. Spread across. Back down a little bit. Okay, so I'm not quite square. Yeah, that'll work. That'll work. I don't want to bring that out any. Okay, that's good. Holy moly, we're at 40 minutes already. Man, time goes fast when you're drawing. Wow, I thought we'd be a lot further than that by now. Oh my goodness. Wow. Okay. Yeah. This is obviously going to take a couple episodes, maybe, to finish up. So let's see. Go in and do this real quick. Let's see. I wanted that to be a lighter color. That to be a darker color. This to be a lighter color, this to be a darker color, and maybe even a gradient. Make that a gradient. And I want it to be white. I want it to be kind of pale white. I don't think we want that to be that dark. No, I don't want it to be that dark. I don't want it to come up. That maybe? Yes, that's the same one. That's pretty new. Well, it doesn't look too bad. Alright, let's see what happens. That's good. I think that I'm not going to touch that. That looks really good. I might change that color to a dark Undo. I didn't mean to do that. No, I definitely don't want to do that. Okay, we'll leave it alone. Okay. So here's what I'm saying is, let me go ahead and drop in color on the seat as well. So I got to do the seat cushion and then the front of the seat cushion. Let's see. And, yeah. Let's drop in that color there and then drop in the color there. And that there, and then we'll readjust the gradient pattern. Not really. Ha, there it is. Perfect. Perfect. Perfection. Perfection. Yeah, okay, that could work. That could work well. I like that. So I'm gonna add a slightly darker right here on the end. There we go. Perfect. Perfect. There you go. I'll just slap that in there. And then we'll just go ahead and that. So you can kind of see where we're going with this, right? Yeah, so the black will be filler for it. And then the gradients and stuff help it give it the dimension, help it to pop out. So I might work on the chair some more in between just to get it a little further along before we tackle the background. I really don't want to take a lot of shows to do this. I really want to get done fast, but yeah, it's coming along. Do a quick file save. All right, so yeah, not as far as I wanted to, but that was just it saving. Yeah, what do you think? What do you think? Give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Gosh, what am I doing? Okay, webcam. Okay, there we go. All right, so let's wrap this up tonight. It's almost 11 o'clock p.m. Pacific time. I have to get to bed. I'm tired. I'm wiped. We had a big old birthday party here over the weekend, and yeah, it was a lot of fun. Since I'm doing this, I'm wearing my Lego Spaceman space shirt. So it's got Neil deGrasse Tyson and Carl Sagan on it in Lego minifig form. I don't have one of Stephen Hawking. Might be one that should be made now. We need a Stephen Hawking Lego minifig shirt. Alright. So I think that's it for tonight. So as usual, give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Thumbs down if you didn't. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thank you for watching. Thanks for joining me. Hope you learned something. Please, if I passed over something quickly and you want me to clarify something, just ask it in the comments, and I'll be happy to answer. So you all have a great night, and with that, we will end this episode 9, and we'll be back with episode 10, where we'll finish Stephen Hawking's chair, and hopefully the background, something like that.